cash out like it's no motherfucking blackouts. Fuck you mean, bitch. Real bitch, let her ride with the stick.
Welcome
cash out
podcast.
Every time I'm in this bitch,
whole team in the building.
Back at it.
That's feeling right. Good.
We out here.
Feeling good. Real quick, shout out to Who's Wax, Supreme Cannabis. He got the Who's Wax Lemonade. Get next to him at cannagifts.com. Go get your Supreme Cannabis. And they got that THC Lemonade. I got my man in the building with me.
You know that.
Mr. Alex Quo. What up, babe?
Back in the building. Missed y'all last week. We back, though. How y'all doing? How y'all been? What's
up? Miss
the fuck happened last week? Oh, you wasn't here last week.
Yeah. You already forgot I wasn't here?
Yeah. Already? Wow.
Niggas don't fuck with you like that. You know the vibe.
My presence was missed. That's good, though.
No, ain't nobody.
Let me know. Back, though.
I wasn't fucking with Wellie last week.
Wasn't fucking with
oh, you really wasn't?
That shit was funny.
That's what's
funny.
Up. You hear it.
I tuned in. I heard it.
The energy would have been different maybe if you were here.
Lex in here. You see what it is.
Lex is back. What's up?
Lex, get it. What's good, guys? What's
she
good?
Just keeps showing up and shit. I don't know. I didn't even tell her what time we was doing this. When I pulled up, she pulled up too.
This nigga disrespectful.
Let's talk about how I ended up here.
I was like, what's good? She's like, what's good? Like, it was a weird energy, but I'm glad you showed up. It's good.
I'm happy you're here. I'm happy.
It's cool.
Thank you.
Special guest in the building, man.
I'm also happy she's here, too. Yes.
All right, cool. Look, one thing we know about Al. Oh, he's going to shoot his shot.
No, I ain't going to do that. I said I wasn't going to do that. I'm not going to miss. I'm not going to shoot my shot. I ain't going
to
do that. That's not me.
Miss.
Yeah, you didn't introduce her yet, so she's missed.
Listen.
Miss. At least it's my ma'am.
Yeah, there we go. Go ahead.
It's bars in the building.
Straight bars.
You understand what I'm saying? Like, this that real rap I'm talking about. Like, not that, you know what I mean? This ain't that, you know, get your titties done, get your ass done, put a thong on, I rap all of a sudden. Real bars.
Mm-hmm. You're looking at me like that.
No, I'm not looking at me like that.
You were looking at me. But the ass thing
that's
and the thong thing, you were looking at me.
I got a lazy eye.
Now the nigga got a medical condition. You see that? Now you got a medical condition. All right, go ahead.
Dirti Diana in the building. What up?
What up, though?
All right.
What's good with you? How you been?
Man, I'm happy to be here.
Oh, no, we good. I'm happy to have you, man.
Your personality
is incredible.
When my man AB hit me and was like, yo, we got to get Dirti Diana on the show, I was like, whenever she's in town, let's get it done.
Yo, shout out to AB Butler back in the game.
AB's a legend. AB's a legend. We're going to get into how legendary he is in a minute.
Okay. Oh, that's AB sitting right there?
Yeah.
Oh, God. Because he's making that face. I'm like, are we talking about him? Okay, all right. Keep going. No, my bad. My bad.
I think this is a regular thing for you. You lost a little bit in the beginning.
Nobody introduced me to him. I was not introduced to him.
He's young. I don't know what to say. I apologize in advance.
Weren't you outside?
I was outside for 2 minutes. I parked and I ran in here.
2 minutes is enough.
Yeah. So, boom, we got Dirti Diana in here. I'm getting right into it. I'm not going to be told this how you start. Mm-mm. Oh. What was it like rapping, spitting, kicking, vibing with the legend DMX?
Oh, my God.
I get right into it.
Oh, my God. It was incredible.
Mm-hmm.
This is a sensitive subject, you know.
Right.
But it was like he was an angel to me. You know what I mean? He opened up. It was like a spiritual, like talking to a spiritual counselor, and it was meant to happen.
Right.
It was meant, like the Jews that he gave me, they were all iconic, all legendary. I just couldn't believe I was in a room with him.
Mm-hmm.
He just opened up and we was spitting, we was vibing. He was giving me advice, telling me what, you know, about the game, what to do, what not to do, messages from God. It was very, very intimate and deep.
You know what's crazy? Almost everybody who's had the chance to sit down with the dog has a similar story. Nobody got no regular shit about DMX.
Yeah.
It was always something heaven sent or something, you know what I mean? Something divine.
Yeah.
And it, like, I love that because the dog wasn't just no rapper. You know what I mean?
Nah.
I went to Rough Riders Cash Money concert. This was when they was on tour. We partied, we rapped, and we fucking prayed.
Absolutely.
Like, what the fuck? This is after Juvenile, BG, Baby, Wayne.
Right.
Lox, Eve. Eve was super crazy. Mm-hmm. Look, we was quiet. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean?
You quiet. Let everybody in prayer?
Yeah, that's the DMX, dog.
Yeah.
That's what's up.
You just know the barking.
I do know the barking. I was going to ask you if you know how to do it next, but I'm going to wait my turn. Go ahead.
Man.
He was barking. He was growling. He was doing everything that you could think of that night. But it was very, very special. Like, he wasn't playing at first. You know, I walked in that room and he was like, why you want to rap? Tell me about yourself. What it is. It was,
wow.
Yeah. It was just real deep and it just touched my soul and everything. He gave me, I left with so much jewels. Nobody, I never met nobody like that.
And I said this the week he passed, nobody will ever be that.
Right.
And you know, we hear that a lot, but nobody can even copy that shit.
Facts.
Like, he was just, what I loved about DMX was he was him. You know, he was spiritual, rapped his ass off, and he was successful. Because a lot of times you see these dudes, they, you know, they do all of these things and they're like, damn, but we don't find out about them till they pass. And then they go platinum after they die and all of that crazy shit. Mm. You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
But with Dog, I'm glad he was able to, like, he got his flowers while he was here.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But he had his light. I'm trying to shed light on you. You listen, I heard the music. You understand?
She's got bars. I can certify it. Coming from me. Like,
thank you. Thank you very much.
It's
look, Alex.
So how you get into the game? Like, how you start rapping?
Oh, man. Just coming up in the Bronx. I mean, Bronx itself is just rough. You come out.
Agreed.
Every corner, people are ciphering. It was just around me. You know what I mean? And then Cool Herc, he saw me at a talent show and he kind of took in and was like, okay, I need to introduce some producers. I need you, you know what I mean? So I knew something was there. And every cypher, the guys, they would be intimidated. You know what I mean? That's when you know. Like,
okay.
Oh.
You had kind of that clout behind you.
Yeah, gas me up. You know what I mean?
Look, you need that guy.
I'm big on gas.
I mean, it only gets
big on gas.
I'm super big on gas.
She said, I'm super big on gas. I like,
gas me up, gas me up. That's good.
But nah, that's dope, man. So it seems like Legend's been taking to you since day one.
Yeah, absolutely.
Cool Herc, AB, Dog, Fat Joe.
But let me ask you this, though.
So regular shit.
Definitely got to ask, though. Was it something like, do you feel like it found you? Or is it something like, yo, let me try rapping and see how it go? Or was it just, did it come, like, I know some people, they got to sort of dabble in a lot to find what they niche is. You know what I'm saying?
No, it was always natural because I always was writing. I always wrote little poems and I noticed it was from young.
It always kind of had like a flow of rhythm to it.
Always had a flow of rhythm.
So when you were young, you were writing about what? Like everything that was just happening?
Just happening. Just, yeah.
Bad and good?
Yeah, a lot was bad. A lot was emotional. You know what I mean? A lot. You know, because I lost my father, lost my grandmother. Just watching around. When you're in the hood, a lot of things happen.
A lot of things is happening.
Yeah, guns, bullets, things is just happening. That right. You're seeing, and as you see it, you can either talk about it or you could be about it.
Two things for certain. The hood gonna be the hood.
They gonna do what they're
gonna be the hood. Mm-hmm. It's just up to you to talk about it. Boom, put it this way.
Too, yeah.
And it don't change. It's not gonna change.
It's the same shit. Yeah, you're right.
I've been out the hood for fucking 20 years now. I moved out the hood when I was 9. I know what the elevator still smell like.
Oh, wow.
You know what I mean? I know what it still smell like. It don't go nowhere. Like? It smell like this nigga car. No, I know what it smell like.
What are you talking about? My car smell bad good. Hey, yeah. Chipotle chicken ranch is actually what it smells like right now. I left some food overnight, but that being said.
Overnight.
Anyway. Nah, but it's definitely something I could learn to respect. You know, you're rapping about what goes on in your life, too. So it's definitely, because that's what, you know, it's something interesting. When he was talking about DMX just now, you even said the first thing he did, he asked you, why'd you get into this? What'd you do? Why'd you do what you do? That sort of thing.
Absolutely.
When I first met this guy, actually, because we both comedians, when I first met him, he did that same shit. I just got to put respect on his name. He did that same thing.
Yeah.
Except what he'll do, he'll have me like do laps when I do it. We did like a mad giant ass walk around Times Square.
Yeah,
And he quizzing me on shit. Why are you doing comedy? I'm catching my breath. Like, yeah.
Because you're not going to be out here wasting my fucking time. We're not going to have that.
Was you laughing during the walk?
No, he wasn't laughing.
I just watching.
I was hungry.
Nah. Listen, shut the fuck up. Just answer these questions. You know what I mean? Like, because the nigga laughed too much as it is. I want to let
shit
like
funny out here.
Just entertain, like I try to tell
shit
people.
Funny out here.
Entertainment, it's millions of dollars out here. You just gotta go get it.
Get
that's it.
Back.
You do the shit the right way. Make smart moves. You're gonna have to run from the money. You can't get all of it. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
So I try to show them that like this shit not a game. It's just called the game. Ain't nobody playing out here. Nobody fucking playing.
Cut
you see motherfuckers driving these Maybachs and these Rolls Royces. They're not playing. They rap too. They joke too. You see what I'm saying?
All of that.
It's just called the game. That's just what niggas call it when they talking to their friends. This shit is not nobody playing at all. No.
Business, man.
Let me now. Can I jump in with another question? Or we got another question? I got questions. I got questions. All right. So certain points in like just careers in general, we both call it this actually. We have like oh shit moments where it's like, you know, 1 minute you may be doing your regular thing, but then like life could just change like that, you know? Mm-hmm. I want to ask you what your first oh shit moment was, where you were just kind of, you know, maybe you was in the rap game, but then something, maybe you met somebody. It could be DMX, may not be DMX, but maybe you met somebody or you had an opportunity. And after that, you know, things were just different.
I probably shit it on my head. Oh shit, mad oh shit moments and shit it and shit it and shit it. You know what
That's
I mean?
Good.
But to be honest, all the moments I had, nothing tops DMX. That was the old.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Because he gave me the game. You understand? And I'm listening to it from a legend. That was like my biggest, oh shit. I heard it out of his mouth. He done been through everything that he could possibly been through.
That's dope.
Has gone through. So mm-hmm. what he gave to me, it was like, oh shit. You know what I mean? I left there and then I had to kind of rearrange it. I took it in. I had to rearrange things that I was doing wrong. You know what I mean? I took lessons out of it.
Biggest thing you learned? If you could share it. I mean, the streets want to know.
Tone it down. Come, you know what I mean? Tone it down and you gotta kinda be with them to get them.
Mm.
You know? Be with them.
Right.
They understand you. You can't just tone it down. That's the biggest thing.
In other words, you don't just start out rich and famous.
No.
Nah.
Nah, I'm from the hood. I got to show that.
Yeah.
The hood,
get at me, dog. I get it. Yeah. Nah, that's what I fuck with.
Yeah.
Because when I heard your music, first thing I said was this Foxy Brown. I don't know if you've heard that before, but to me, I'm like, it's those level of bars. Like to me, Foxy Brown's one of the dopest.
Facts.
Male or female.
Facts.
You know what I mean? So I'm like, nah. This is the rap I fell in love with.
That's what's up. I get it a lot. I get it.
You know what I mean? This the rap. Look, not too much. Could we just get a people a taste of what you got? Like, I know we got the single Cash out there in these streets. I know we got that. But I just need the people to hear something.
This is the part I was waiting for. Go ahead.
Go. Hey, yo. Pharaoh Gummo to flip, some Skeeno buckle to hips, ice challenge the wrist, and blow a sack up on Fifth. Spin through the block in a 4, 5, or 6. I bet the house I hit him with a 4, 5, or 6. Lean up on them. They ain't trying to play clean up on them. Go press and put the steam up on them. They don't really want the clean up on them. Slick talking, sticking and moving. Catch you, put the beam up on them. From the other side of things, where we robbing bang. We ain't tuck our chain even if we on the train. Ain't nothing like a bitch from the ex nigga. Once you pop once, your man gonna turn to your ex nigga.
Wait, she's still going. She's still going. Okay. All right. All right. If you got a rewind button at home, hit that again. Run that one back again.
She said, we don't tuck our chains even on the trains, nigga. Whoa. All right. Damn.
Very effortless.
I'm a bitch ass nigga. Let's just put that out.
Look,
there.
That was, he's sweating after that. Look at his face.
Respectfully, I got my shit tucked in right now.
Wow. That's what's up.
I told y'all we not playing.
We not messing around. Okay.
Yes, you don't want rap no more.
No.
You don't want rap no more. See, motherfucker.
I never said I rap. Actually, I never said I had bars. I never said.
Yeah, let me hear that.
I write poetry sometimes. I don't rap about the train. No. I don't do that.
Say no.
Not those bars.
Yeah. Ain't no regular shit, man.
Wow.
So, boom. Fat Joe co-signs you.
Facts.
You understand what I'm saying? Busta co-signed.
Busta was another incredible talk. You know what I mean?
You don't just talk to Busta. You got to experience Busta.
That was an experience.
Yeah.
Please explain.
Tell me how that
was. I got to hear about that. Go ahead.
Yeah.
Shout out to Busta, man. Even when I met Busta, his introduction was different than anything that I experienced. Mm-hmm. You know, he introduced me like a kiss in the form of a cross. It was blessings. You know what I mean? And then we started talking and and he's just like, you gotta kill him, you know what I mean? You eat what you kill, and then in the shortest way to say what he said. But it was just like, I told him, you know, I was in an interview with Violators and we was talking, you know what I mean? And I was listening, and he know that I listened because I got the book that he said to get, mm-hmm. you know what I mean? And that book is so deep, And now I understand, after reading the book, I understand Busta's whole everything, even how he rhyme, everything about him. I said, you know, you got that book, Queen? You got that book? You know what I mean? It was a vibe. And we probably sat and talked for about maybe 7 minutes. And I took away everything right there. And that 7 minutes, I left with something.
Wow.
So they're not just talking to me. I'm leaving with.
Now they're giving you gems you could take with for the rest of your life. Absolutely. Yeah.
And you in a position where you're learning from all of the greats, you know?
Yeah, and it ain't like I don't do it. You tell me a book, I'm going to get the book, I'm going to read the book.
There you go.
It's something you're telling me for a reason.
I'm going to make it. You're not going to hide this shit from me. I'm going to make it.
But it's great, though, to get something out of it, you know, like something great out of it that really affects you moving forward. Because, you know, I guess a lot of people who end up, you know, I guess taking whatever their poems and whatever their talent is and go ahead and try in the industry now, you know, I guess a lot of them see that they fail in getting any kind of like great advice. You know, that's good to hear that you got something like that. But these people are big, so.
Thank you.
And you open to learn too. So many people I feel like just aren't, like they'll take in some information, but if it's not, like I'm sure you've heard criticism.
What they wanna hear.
Yeah, you've heard criticism maybe you didn't wanna hear, right?
Yeah.
But you, I guess
I could take criticism, tell me something.
You have to.
It gotta be right though, you know what I mean?
Right.
What?
She said it got me right though.
The disguise criticism with talking shit.
Yeah.
It's like, all right, nigga.
And he gotta recognize.
I'm still from the hood. Don't get it twisted. She said, niggas don't tuck their shit on the train, nigga. It's a reason. It got that thing on them. That thing. Whatever that thing is, they got it on them. Yo, man, this fucking good part. Yo. So boom. So what's next for you? I mean, I feel like, yo, you could really do something crazy in this game.
Thank you.
Immediately.
Thank you.
I don't think it. I know it, but keep going.
Oh, I appreciate it. You're touching my heart.
You pretty and you can rap?
Oh, thank you.
Don't let that shit slide. Lex shooting her shot. Oh, I know I'm going to shoot their shot.
Why you always got to say somebody else shooting their shot?
Lexi.
I'm just commentating. But God, I'm sorry. I'm not coming. Right. Not shooting your shot. It's so good. Hey, I don't know, man.
No, just giving a compliment.
Yeah. Give me my flowers. Thank you.
You're very welcome.
It's all good. She said, all right, cool, but I'm saying though, what's good?
But I'm saying though, what's good?
She's humble over there.
That's what you think. She better check your DM. She already in there, motherfucker.
Yo, cut the shit, man.
Think she humble, huh?
Don't pick on me right now.
She a savage. Oh,
didn't I tell you that?
We was interviewing this other female. She was like, Al was shooting her shot. She was like, Al, nah, chill.
Who was I shooting my shot with?
And Al, you know, he young. He young. Come on, man, y'all fucking the Joker. So
what's the question? I don't even know what you're talking about.
So you know what I mean? Whatever, they fucking joke up. And then she was like, nah, I already hit her with the 9-inch. So you got to be careful for her. You got to. I'm not going to.
He literally
said that.
You see how he just made a whole scenario?
I don't even speak like that.
I got your back. These motherfuckers on some other shit.
Okay, got
me personally, I think they fucking. But that's some whole other shit they got going on.
He just airing all the beef. You see this?
That's some shit they got going on.
Just airing beef.
You came back.
We're talking music.
I'm just talking about the sweat on his forehead, because the last time I was sweating in this studio, he had him do a close-up on my face.
No, he said something about
this motherfucker.
He said something about
sweating like hell. Shit. You want to switch spots? I can sit next to her. You can't handle it. It's fine. Don't worry about it. I can sit over there. It's okay.
85
y'all
degrees.
Y'all probably have a lot of friends. Heat over there. Playing. He on that seat over there, you know?
It's just.
But nah, what's next? What's your plans for this year?
Oh, man. I got a lot of things in the work. I got the EP coming out.
All right.
Okay.
Self-made/barcode. It's called Barcode. You know, I feel like, and that name came from just everything's a product. You know what I mean? You, as an artist, you become a product. You become the thing that people want. You got to sell it. And working on a movie, you know, getting into the movie scenes and just back in AB, back in the game entertainment is next.
What made you want to do a movie? Or was the opportunity presented to you and then you're just open to it?
Opportunity presented, always open to it.
Yeah.
Open to
it. I like that, yeah.
Expand the brain, you know what I mean? You can't.
Absolutely.
Motherfuckers hit you with a chance to do a movie. That could lead to another movie.
I mean, some people just probably don't have as much confidence, you know?
Oh, no, that's definitely.
I'm after the bag.
Exactly.
That's what I respect.
But she has confidence that she's going to succeed in doing it.
Confidence in the bag. Yeah, I get that. That's what it's all about. Yeah, confidence in the bag. That's what it's about.
To get the bag, you need confidence in yourself.
Now, let me ask you this, though, because it's, I ain't going to lie. I was watching Mad Tupac documentaries for the past like 3 days. So it's one thing. So I'm in tune right now. So very much. But one thing, I haven't too. But the one thing's for sure though, I definitely like asking is, it's easy to ask like how you got into what you do or like why you do what you do. But is there like a message behind what you rap, you know? Or is there like an aim to what it is that you try to do?
Yeah, absolutely. Well, see, Tupac is my favorite artist. By
and me. I could tell just from the bars that you kind of rapped off. I could tell, yeah.
Yeah,
but go ahead.
I like Tupac. I like Biggie. You know what I mean? I listen to those, the Kendrick Lamar's. There's always like a message. Or,
exactly.
You know what I mean? So when I said X had come down on a level, whatever, I'm still involved in the streets. And the, you know what I mean? And I be spitting.
We're going to edit all that shit out. Don't worry about it.
Okay.
The feds be watching.
I'm sorry.
This ain't black. Feds be watching.
I'm just saying.
Video game. It's a video game called The Street. It's not anything to do with
that. I am a product of my environment, is what I'm trying to say. I'm a product of my environment. But as I sit back and I watch, it's what you get out of it and what you take out of it and what you learn. And there's certain records. I don't make every record like that, but when you get that record, you know it's a big record.
Mm-hmm.
So there's a message in that record, and I know that music shapes every generation. I know that people don't understand how powerful music is. So for me to know that, I make sure I throw that in. You know what I mean? So it's always a message. Like it's all, when you really pay attention, people were trying to tell you things, and then when you lose somebody, you talk about it. When you're going through pain, you talk about it. So that's how people know people. You got to really listen mm-hmm. to the lyrics.
Speaking of DMX. That was his whole career. He was just really just talking about his pain.
Exactly.
And his trauma.
Facts. Yes.
And like, he was just saying, it's just me and my dog.
Facts.
Like literally his dog. And he just also considered his friends his dogs too. But where did it start from? It was just him and his dog, boom, talking about their pain. Boom, the world loved. You couldn't have been a bigger, nobody could be a bigger star than DMX. That's crazy.
That's the best message he gave me. He said, talk my pain.
Yeah.
I left that out. It was so much. I can't give you
an answer. No. You're going to be thinking about shit on the way home.
Told me talk my pain, you know what I mean? And then speaking of dog, I'm a dog lover.
Okay.
And I understand what the dog meant when he was talking about the dog. Because to be honest, no matter what you go through, your dog is the loyalist person. They are not leaving your side.
That's true.
Facts.
I like
they
that.
That's why I don't
they
fuck.
They are the most
we
loyal
don't deserve
of all lawyers.
That's why I don't fuck with niggas with cats. Yeah.
He actually.
I love that.
The dog is the most loyal. What are you doing with a fucking cat, bro?
Cats can be loyal.
Yo, but like he'll really carry this shit everywhere. Yeah. My sister invited me and him over to her crib just for like dinner.
Yeah, what's
like,
up with the nine lives, though?
What?
Like, really nine lives. I don't get it, but
I understand that. I'm just
they fall on their feet a lot.
This shit supposed to make sense. I'm good.
I think that was it. I used to watch.
The cartoon. What, cats? The cartoon?
Cat dog. Anyway.
But I think I got a lot of respect for you because you are going that route of talking your pain. I feel like, I mean, at least with like the current generation, it's easy to just be like throat baby and just kind of go that route with it. You know what I'm saying?
Right, absolutely.
But it's like you're out here really talking about your life, you know, talking about the things that you know that's going on.
Yeah, absolutely.
It's a big thing. There's a lot of things going on.
And I do both. So that's what I'm trying to say. Like, you'll get that too.
Mm-hmm.
But then you'll hear the pain. At the same
you appeal to the masses like that too. That's what it's all about. I like that.
That's what I'm talking about.
She gets it.
I get you.
On that wavelength. What you know about wavelength? He can't spell it. It's all right. Don't worry about it. It's okay. It's all right. He can't. Notoriously bad speller. But
let me give you all the background.
You can't spell
Al got. Well, we had a show last night. Al got on stage. He did good.
And
this
did
nigga has been on cloud a thousand.
Funny as fuck. That was me. Funny as fuck productions. That's me.
So yeah. I just kind of let him go. I understand. It's 24-hour period. It's about to run out in 30 minutes.
What was I doing? I was talking my pain.
How many people were there?
I was a lot.
Now, put it this way. In New York City, what they say is like 33%. It wasn't no 33% in there last night. It was packed. It was like 80%. But Al rocked out. He just thinks. So he's on 1,000.
But I'm vibing with what she's saying. It's about speaking your truth. You know, my truth is different from your truth. Yeah, 2 + 2 = 4. But what's my 2 + 2 saying that your 2 + 2 is not saying? You know what I'm saying?
God. Oh, here we go.
Different. Yeah.
Look, she said that was
you see what I'm saying?
He's like, that was
I didn't ask that. Him to clarify none of that shit.
Turn that into a bar right now.
No, I'm sorry. I ain't got no bars. My phone is like no service right now. We got nothing.
You want to spit a
phone? No, actually. We got clips of me spitting bars. I'll just show you that later.
Okay.
You can't spit lame, whack bars in front of someone who actually does this.
I'm so glad you
know. You can't do this.
What am I going to do? Yeah. People go watch this. Thousands of other people, wow, he's whack. No, it's not, that's not how this.
Oh, whack ass nigga. Yeah.
No, when it was just
that's your, in the that's comments, your
when it was just these whack. Two, oh, I spit all my bars.
So
I'm gonna leave whack too. But now are you here? Nah, shut that shit down.
I'm gonna go ahead and leave a comment right now. Oh, whack ass nigga. Fuck that.
No, it's okay. He was there. Funny as fuck productions last night. That was good. But no, really, it is about preaching your truth, you know? I'll tell you, my shit yesterday only got funny when I talked about the pain that I went through, right? Yeah. Took somebody out to Cheesecake Factory. How we spend $150? How we do that? At Cheesecake. We didn't even buy Cheesecake. How the fuck did that happen?
Wait, you said how did you spend $150?
At Cheesecake Factory. How do you do that?
Easy. It's not cheap. And
oh,
cheap.
She's dangerous.
Ooh, don't bring that guy. Look at that guy.
I ate all of my appetizers, she all of at me my like, dinner, how all of my dessert, and like, 100 drinks.
Easy. That's the problem. But yeah,
Cheesecake Factory's not a line to spend that.
I want
to
hear the joke.
You want to hear the joke? That was the joke.
That was the fucking joke.
That was the joke. Yeah.
It's pretty much a joke.
Yeah, that was the joke. Yeah. I'm fucked up. That's the joke. That was the
problem. My bad.
Speaking of dates, what's a perfect date for you?
See, I'm easy going. You know what I mean? I am the girl from the block. You know what I mean? But I feel like you got to show me the world first. You got to show me that you in it for respect. You're not coming in, taking me. I'm not going to the Cheesecake Factory on those.
Okay, so how do we show you that we in it for respect? Like, how do we just want to know?
Lay out the roses, pull up something nice. Open the door.
Treat me like
open
I'm some.
Okay. Like the little things.
That's a big
one. I love the little things.
She said,
being polite.
You gonna sit in the car? I'm gonna be inside waiting.
It's their mannerisms too. Those matter. Okay. What about somebody in the
after a while? Then we could go to McDonald's. You know what I mean?
Right. After you did the right thing,
you showed us. You know what I mean? Show you guys. Got it.
There goes. Oh no, it's good. Might as well take it down.
It's cool.
What about somebody in the industry? Would you ever go out with somebody?
They just let niggas know he in here. It's the dog.
That's the dog right there, yeah.
But go ahead.
Ask your question.
Excuse me. Now I is my... You like, ask your question now.
Well, X showed up.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Somebody take that. Wow. What I just ask? Would you ever date anyone that's in the industry?
That's an interesting question.
Sound like one word.
That's a good question. So... Me, I'm a I believe in love stories. Mm-hmm.
Right? Fairy tales.
Yeah, fairy tale. I'm the fairy tale girl. You fall in love. But at the same time, you just
she's falling in love.
You always hear like
like that thing falling.
Yeah,
back.
He loves me. This Willie. Will
yeah, yeah, no, it's falling. It's fucking. It's let it fall. Okay. Okay.
It's okay. But I wouldn't say no, I won't.
You're open to
it. I'm open, but at the same time, you see all the stories there. You know what I mean?
And yeah. That scares
celebrity
shit
marriages.
Out of yeah. me. Reality TV scares me. I know some of it is whatever.
But you can't say who's your match. Like, yeah. You can never say who.
Mm-hmm. You never know.
That's not what I see, though. I'm going to get somebody in the industry. I don't care about none of that. You know what I mean?
Good. So what? So all right, cool. You don't care about none of that. What do you care about then?
Mm-hmm. I care about myself. You know what I mean? My family.
There you go. That's the right answer.
All right, boom. So Stevie J's, boom. Stevie J hits you up. You already know what type of time he's on.
Right.
Do you even engage in that? Or you just like, hey, let's see where his head at.
Shout out to Stevie J. Stevie J is my guy. You know what I mean?
Shout out to Stevie J.
You better shut this scenario down. You better shut this shit down.
Respect, because Stevie J is really a legend. Yeah,
absolutely.
These young niggas don't know.
Yeah, okay.
I only
it's always the young niggas.
I only knew about him because always the young niggas fault. And I had to look
put it
up.
This way. Y'all like Biggie, right?
Of course.
Yeah. All right, then. Y'all think did the beats. He's a part of the team.
Right.
But you know, anyway.
Listen,
you keep calling yourself older. It's not my problem.
No, I'm just not, cause see, y'all are that
y'all
young
what?
Dumb age. Yeah.
Don't speak for him.
Yeah, don't speak for him.
I mean, wait, for me too. Yeah. You said us.
Y'all the same age.
Okay.
So when I say, you know, what do you care about? It's like
business. I ain't gonna front. I'm all about my business.
All
about my business.
So we don't gotta worry about TMZ running up on Dirty Diana stumbling out the club because she done had too much to drink.
Nah, my fam. She was shot a Henny. Bring me a shot. Take a shot. I'm like, I'm not gonna take my shot until after the interview. I handle my business first.
I like that.
It's big. See, it's a big thing too. The people you keep around you. Mm-hmm. I'm so big on that personally. Just like the energy, because you. It's what show me your friends, I'll show you your future. I'm big on that, right?
Oh,
it's like the people around you. Yeah, it's true. Because if you hang with whack people, you're gonna be whack.
But
if you hang with five whack people, congratulations, you whack person number six.
Congratulations, you played yourself.
Exactly what I'm saying. But if you hanging around people who are going somewhere in life, It's just how it works. Law of attraction. You're just going to be whatever y'all trying to do. So
yeah.
I've always been big on that, you know?
I'm huge on energy. That's my thing. I read The Secret. I read energy books.
Oh, The Secret? Yeah.
Like I can walk in a room and know I don't belong. You know what I mean?
You feel it. It's always something there, you know?
Absolutely.
Is that something you pick on my... Is that something you feel like a lot? And I could speak for the comedy world, right? Sometimes in the comedy world where it's like, you know, you could walk into a place and you can just kind of feel how just people just kind of giving you the energy, right?
Right.
In a negative way. Is that something you feel... synonymous, I guess, in the rap game, or is it like?
Yeah, you feel it, you know. And if you don't know, your partner know. You know what I mean? Somebody around you is gonna know because sometimes you off. Sometimes
you're wrong. And plus, I mean, you learn, especially like, I mean, when you first start out, then you just learn along the way how people move and shit, and you learn to keep your eyes open.
That's what I'm talking
about. But you still fuck up anyway. But you learn after the fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth time, but it's okay. What about did you ever find yourself having to, I guess, drop people in your life because they weren't, I guess, supportive of you?
Yeah, I dropped somebody in a minute. I'm the block queen.
I don't know if you're going
to
block you.
Me too, but I had to learn to be that way.
I'm not even going to block them. I'm just like, all right, cool.
Oh, this motherfucker lying. Yeah. I'm not came in with the facts yesterday. Do you know that if you block somebody on Instagram, that they go track your other account? That's this nigga the other day.
That's
the
other shit.
He had the block facts the other day.
Yeah. I'm big on.
Yeah, what is that?
See, niggas had me drunk off that 1942 one night.
No, this is Tuesday.
I know.
You're responsible for your own
and so they had me drunk off the 42 one night, and then I like to give people fun facts.
Nigga, the fun fact.
And the shit was a hit one night, so I kept the facts going.
Hey, stupid.
Just drop jewels on niggas. Yeah. I would just tell
him. He called me. Did you know?
If you block somebody on Instagram now, you could block any count they may make in the future. That was just what he was talking about. But
this is coming from the guy who says he never blocks anybody.
How are they going to know? Yeah. How are they going to know?
I exercise all right.
How the hell do you know?
You want to ask Instagram?
She got 23 accounts on the gram.
I don't have
23
and 7.
her son got an Instagram too.
My what?
What?
Yeah, that's my point. She ain't even got a son, but he got a gram. He got a gram. Okay, she said last week.
That was good.
Changed my mind early.
She said it last week.
I changed my mind and I said it was more of like, you know, babies being on clouds and advertising, but I would never put them on Instagram because all the shit was on.
Like, remember when we first started, she said, I had an attitude with him last week. I'm talking about why you ain't follow my son back. I'm like, you got a kid. You're not even pregnant. What is wrong?
How you know?
I'm done with you.
Whoa.
Oh, shit.
But still.
She looking at me like I'm talking too much.
You are talking too much. What is
you
that?
You talking too much family
this is
drama.
What he do. This is what he do when he's a guest on. He going to paint himself
as an
angel.
I said too much.
Right? That's what he do.
I fucked up again.
But let me,
no damn halo.
Let me ask you this, though. On the topic of just kind of related to what she was asking. When you first decided this is what you was going to do. Mm-hmm. Now, obviously, there are people who are going to be in your corner, right?
Right.
But I'll go out on a limb and say most people probably thought you was crazy for thinking what you were about to do, right?
Right.
Right. So I guess from that, what did you do personally? Because this is something that, you know, we dealt with too when we said we were going to be comedians, right? Is there something that you had to do for yourself? Or you're just like, you know what? Let me tune all these people out. I know what I'm doing is right. Or was that like a challenge for you in the beginning?
That's a long
answer. I kind of separated myself, you know what I mean? I rose dolo, you know what I mean? I don't really have friends. I have people that I know that got my back. Call them family, but friends, I kind of left all of them.
You outgrew them.
Because it's like I'm focused on something and y'all doing other things. Like,
yeah,
I have a homegirl around and she'll be sleeping with everybody, but it's like you said, who you around, I make you
look. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So you kind of got to know what you want and who you are and remove what is not supposed to be around. And I rose dolo. I ain't gonna front. Everything I do dolo.
Yeah, the same with me. I keep him around, but I know he not gonna. I know he not gonna sleep with nobody. Cause women don't fuck with him like that as it.
Meanwhile, this nigga at the gas station just yesterday. Yo, $10 regular. He's struggling.
He became family though. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But even when you're with him,
chicks
he's
ain't
alone.
Fuck with him.
Even when you're with him, he's alone. He forgot you were here last week.
No. I know he knew I wasn't here.
So be honest, I have people with the same that has the same vision around me.
Now, that's very important.
But your success speaks to that. You know what I'm saying?
You ain't never got to drag nobody to the studio, drag nobody to a show. They getting you up. They turning you up.
Yep.
Yo, come on, let's go. Da, 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 da. You know what I mean? You got good management behind you. He don't fuck around.
Back today, like, yo.
He don't fuck around.
7 o'clock.
It's hard though when you don't have like people even in the entertainment industry around you or anything similar that can even like go to the studio with you, like you said, or give you some friendly advice as a friend or something. Right. But in industry, I'm scared to even make friends, man.
But I feel like, why are you, you know, that's how you need that. I feel
No, you need the trust with the business, but it's the friendship factor. Because then nobody. I feel like it kind of gets, I don't know.
I mean, yeah, there's that. It's a lot of weird energy, but you need that. That's how, you know, it all kind of go together.
I feel like the right people are going to gravitate towards you eventually, you know?
Because it's energy.
You keep moving in your direction. If you keep going, like if we on a highway and I know I'm exit 6, right? There're going to be hella cars at exit 1.
Here we go.
But when I'm at exit 5, it's like, "Oh, we all going to the same exit, right?"
He lost me at exit 6.
Exactly, cuz you still on exit 1. And that's my point.
I ain't going to front. You're going to have to give me the number cuz I'm going to
As you keep going, people going to turn off on their own exits, you know what I'm saying? You going to go past those cuz that's not what you trying to
do. Or they're going
to
try to ride your tail.
That's another thing too.
Yeah. And then bye bye.
But they're gonna be a cop in the left lane to show you that you're not gonna be going anywhere because they're gonna pull you
over. Where's the hope?
Because you got warrants.
Where does the hope go after that?
Put it this way: since you dropped that new single, Cash Out, how many new cousins you got?
Oh,
that's funny.
Yeah, niggas is gonna be related. You know that.
That's funny.
That's the
cuz. What? Who is this?
Right?
Cousin.
Yeah. Whoa. I ain't gonna front. My mother came like, who is these people? I'm like, no, from the other side that, you know what I mean? She said
from down south.
To.
Yeah.
From down south.
From down south.
A family you didn't even know you had.
A lot of new people, they come.
And they're gonna keep coming. They're gonna keep coming, but you got your head on right. It's
you
all
gotta
good.
Wean, you gotta ball, you wean it out.
You know when they really gonna come out the woodwork? When AB hit that button. He ain't hit it yet.
Okay.
He bought to. He's my man.
Uh-oh, what's the button?
He's smirking over there.
Yeah, he's smirking big time. What's the button?
It's a big smirk.
Tell him go ahead and hit that button called 50.
Face, man.
Tell him go ahead. Tell him go ahead and hit that button.
What's the button?
Tell him go ahead and hit that button called 50. He got the number. That's what I'm saying.
Oh, okay.
He got the number. He got... Go ahead, hit that button.
I don't know nobody.
50 got about 50 TV shows.
Facts. Mm-hmm. Facts.
I mean, 50, man, you know, money. Look out for your niece real quick. Yeah. She acting.
Uncle.
I mean, that's what it is. When he hit that 50 cent button, you're going to get a lot of new cousins. It's going to be a whole
If you want power, I'm your cousin now. just understand. If you want power, I'm your cousin. I'm sorry.
Well, we know who the groupie up here is. There's groupies, you know.
Not ashamed.
It's all about the people you keep around you.
Hey, look.
The people you know not to keep around you. Nigga, fire. They don't even know.
I'm her cousin, her son, her brother. I'm everything. I don't give a fuck.
Yo, her son.
Oh, hoe ass nigga. God damn. Can't control
yourself.
I
don't give a fuck. I'm everything.
My cousin.
My cheeks hurting.
That's how I am every time I'm here.
No,
but only because of Quo, not because of Willie.
Hey. That's funny as fuck production.
Sometimes.
Gotta have that one hater in the room. At least you know who it is.
I'll hit him next.
Oh
man,
so
I can't.
Man. Jump right out of character. Oh, I can't wait to be. I'm her uncle. What the fuck are you talking about?
Right, I don't know about that one.
This fucking guy. He's something.
I'm the family reunion. Fuck that. I don't care. I'm there.
That's crazy. But nah, stay on him. Make sure he hit that button for you. He got it. He got it.
Okay.
I know who Lil AB Godfather is. 50. That's not, I'm not lying. This shit funny, but I'm not lying.
Come on, tell me more.
She want to know what's going on. She want to know what's going on.
I'm telling you, that's a little, you know, Lil Amy. That's his godfather. All right, this is perfect. This is
some
very shit.
That's my little guy.
Oh. Y'all stupid.
You didn't tell me. Oh.
Go on 50 Cent page and just scroll. 50 B post, yo. I'm not making this shit up. I'm not.
Make it up.
AB's really, AB my man. He really my man. That's all I know this shit, man. But nah, AB's good dude. You in good hands.
But is he your man? Oh, okay.
Exactly. Exactly.
Checks off, man. This is
all right. Shit, man.
He wanted to know.
That's good. Yeah, the streets want to know. Yeah.
You know what's crazy, though? When I grew up, my favorite rapper in the Rough Riders was Dragon. That was my favorite rapper.
Shout out to Drag.
I was in the studio with Drag when he was after the Rough Rider situation, and he was signed to Full Surface with Swiss. In the studio with him, I got to see him work. This, like, he's a machine with it. That was the first person I seen one take a song. Just one take. Brrr, boom.
He's a beast.
Yeah.
You got to add him to the legends that inspired me.
Yes.
Because me, you know, me and Drag did a record together.
Yeah. That's what I was getting to. You see my segue? I was getting into it.
Okay,
God.
You want to do the introduction?
No. Okay.
So,
I be listening to Drag freestyles every week. When he miss a week, I'm on edge.
Yeah, he's, oh my God.
That's bars.
Absolutely.
Hood environment. They don't know what we're talking about.
Yeah, I know what we're talking about. What are you talking about?
You want to have a separate interview?
Yeah, I'm trying to get to that.
Always
trying to what?
But actually, that being said, can I actually, you actually kind of touched on it. Your biggest influences, kind of, whether it be from the jump, from where you are now, just people who you'd say, while you were finding your own style, maybe it helped you kind of guide you towards, you know, being able to find yourself.
I always like Lauren. I like the way Lauren carried herself. So Lauren Hill, mm-hmm. Pop, Big, and just Jay-Z. Like, I always listened to the Biggies, that type of music. I was a little girl, but
right,
legends.
That's who I came up listening to. You know right. what I mean? Little Kim, oh, what? You know what I mean? But those are the people. But still, I like Nicki Minaj. I like Cardi. I like, you know, I like people that do music and do business that can handle it, because people can't handle it. You'll see them and then you won't.
A lot of people want to do business and can't. Right. That is very important. She is absolutely right.
Yeah, there's actually an artist that was just on Instagram. I don't remember who though.
I mean, you see Kevin Hart when you go to Chase Bank. Like, everybody wants to do business, but some people just literally can't.
Some people quit the industry.
They just can't.
I see them writing like they're about to quit the industry because, you know, of whatever goes on, and they can handle, like, I guess, what it comes with. Drama, whatever it comes with.
It's a lot. At a certain level, you know it's going to be cocaine and white women. You know that. That's going to happen.
Okay, I'm down.
No,
I didn't mean it like that. No,
see?
What I said was,
I didn't mean it any other way.
Mom was probably going to hear that one. No.
I was
just saying. No, I'm down as in I registered what you said. I registered.
No.
That registered.
You never say you're down when you understand something.
That registered. Okay.
I baited him.
That was
so
a bait.
Good.
That was
good, good bait.
I was listening.
Nigga said, I'm down.
Yeah, they were pretty quick too. You didn't really think about it. Yeah. Pretty quick.
All I said was, I understood. I understand.
It's all good, man.
I got a question. Whatever. So have you found that maybe it's tough for you to deal with anything, any particular thing mentally, whether it be maybe, I don't know. Well, actually, no, let me just open the floor to you. Anything in particular have you found that's caused like a mental strain? Or you seem like you're handling things really well, but I know appearances can be, you know, it's like one thing, but in actuality.
It is what it is. I'm going to tell you what it is with me. You know what I mean? I'll tell you what it is. You know? But most of the time with me, I get along with most people. I know how to wean and bob and weave, but my main thing, I don't trust nobody. That's my biggest.
That's a good thing though, honestly.
I don't trust nobody. So I have to make sure that's who's around me. And that's it. Like, that's it for me. As long as I got the right people around me, I'm going to do what I do because I'm comfortable.
I fuck with that. That's it. That's it.
So I listened to the D-Rose record, You and Drag On. But I have my own opinion. But what do you think sets you apart from different MCs nowadays? Like, different from the Cardis, the Nickys, the Dream Dolls? What the sweeties? What separates you from them?
Yeah, I'm more of a spiritual type of person. You know what I mean? I study, like I said, the people that I study. Everything's hip hop lyrics. I study the game. Then there's the business side. I'm an entrepreneur. I like to do things how I do things, and to be honest, I bring people in. I draw people in to me, and I think it's just the entrepreneurship as a female supporting other females. Mm-hmm. And then studying the game. My thing is hip hop lyrics, where it came from, taking it back. And it just, me knowing that spiritually, I could connect with people. I know that gift, like how I get people in. And it's just a difference. It's a different vibe. I like to carry myself differently. And you're going to get it. You know what I mean? You'll get it.
Yeah, I like that.
Nah, that's dope.
That's that right there, yeah.
You talk about being an entrepreneur. Now, I know you set up in Atlanta. I seen the, what you got? You got like a nail salon or something out there.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm in tune in the street.
You got a nail salon too?
Yeah, I'm in tune for the street.
Go get your pedicure.
I don't need it. I'm good. I don't need no pedicure.
I like it.
What's the name of the nail salon?
Regency Salon.
Regency Salon?
Yeah, that's slash red carpet.
Where's it at?
It's in Georgia.
When did you open it?
The grand opening is June.
Oh, shit.
Around my birthday. So it could be a birthday celebration slash EP release slash.
Shout it out. Let people in Georgia know exactly where it's at.
Oh, absolutely. And then I'm looking for some. I got like 3 people working in there already. I need nail techs. I need a masseuse. I need a therapist.
Damn, I knew I should have went to school for
an eye tech.
Hey, you're
looking for some more hair tech. So.
Oh, so y'all doing hair. Y'all doing everything.
Yeah, it's a spa.
One stop shop.
They got everything. Yeah. Drive the window. Okay.
That's nice.
they got it all. Goddamn. Shit.
Spa, nail salon, and you can get your hair done at the same time. You know what I mean? So if y'all in Georgia, Johns Creek, make sure y'all come through Regency Salon, red carpet. You know, I'm there. I'll be there. I'm not one of those.
Right.
I'm going to be there, make sure I get it all going, and I'll pop in and pop out. I don't do hair. You know what I mean?
Right. Nah, that's what's up. That's what's up. So she really, I'll tell you, we ain't got no regular people up here, bro. She really doing it.
What made
it.
You want to open up a spa?
I got you. She said earlier. The bag.
Okay. Yeah, but still, that's not known. Besides the bag. I thought you were going to say something else and I actually missed it. No, I thought you were saying something specific. No, I didn't miss that.
If you're just chasing
the bag, you could really go for anything. You have interest, obviously, in... You're gonna make me cough.
Uh-oh.
I ain't make you do shit. That's COVID making you cough. Not me, motherfucker.
That ain't funny.
But obviously, you have some sort of interest in any of that, all right? No, I just want to shit. It's not just, I get it's about the bag.
You're on point.
You know, like you pop in and out and you want to be there. I know people that open up a business or invest in a business, right. And you know, they're not always doing that because they just know how much money it brings in. Shit.
Right. But she also, I got you.
All right, no, forget it now.
She said, I'm from the streets.
That's still not.
So what she's trying to tell you is, I know niggas steal, so I'm there. I got that thing on me, that Thule. Yo, you understand what I'm saying?
I don't think she's
that's crazy.
Right. She said, I'm there. Too, I'm right. The boss. What's wrong?
The Bronx is different, too. Let me tell you.
I need some direct shit.
Hey, don't get no more direct. Did you not listen to what the fuck she said?
Listen.
She don't tuck her shit in on the train. Nigga, what? She got that steam on her. Yo, I never heard a nigga say they got that steam on them.
But I got that.
Woo! Yo, that's a different type of hot, bro. You know
what? BX born and raised. You could tell.
Bro, yeah, I was making tea this morning. Yeah. And I burnt my hand on the steam.
Good.
So when she said got that steam on me, I was like,
you did tea this morning? Oh, yeah. I thought you was on Ramadan. This is the worst Ramadan cat you ever gonna meet in your whole life. This motherfucker. Go ahead, tell the world how you just totally go.
I forgot to tell y'all, there's a nigga in here that be snitching too. I forgot to tell y'all. It's a lot going
God
on.
God is here. He saw you drink that tea and burn your hand. That was God who burned
God
your hand.
God see everything, man. He do.
God
right.
Did burn your hand.
But the thing is, I said I made the tea. Didn't I say I consumed it? But
you didn't consume it because
he's on the witness stand cooperating. We see where he's going with his.
I'm just saying, I report the news. You know what I'm saying? If it's a cloudy day, I'm gonna tell you there's clouds up.
Because you see them and everyone
else sees it. Oh, Bill Butel ass nigga.
What'd he say? What
Bill Butel. Y'all know about Bill Butel.
He cussed me out in French. What'd he say?
Eyewitness news.
I gotta look up what that be. What Bill Butel?
Oh, Sam champion ass.
Okay. I fucks with Sam. He cool.
I fucks with Sam.
Sam's a cool nigga. Shout out to Sam champion.
That's a snitch, man. I'm sorry you had to see all that, you know. You know, it's like when you go over somebody's house and they ain't got their shit together. You're like, you got to put niggas in check. I told you clean the bathroom. Now she got to go to the bathroom and the shit ain't clean.
Motherfucker don't even clean his own crib. All right, never mind. We good.
What are you talking about?
I don't even listen to this.
I don't even know what you're saying.
Oh, no, it's his bathroom really be fucked?
No, not me. Yo,
Dan,
his crib. I'm done. No,
what? What you can find in his car, now this bathroom? I ain't you.
Shit's not dirty, bro.
No, I was saying.
You know your shit dirty when I walk into the crib to go, yo, we smell it here, dog.
Cause I was making turkey chili, bro. Come on, what are you doing?
Soon as I walk in the crib, yo, we smell it here.
I told you guys my stomach hurts.
That's funny. We're going to get these jokes off. That shit going to happen.
Making my Look, if I'm lying, tell me I'm lying. But he said that. I'm like, he asked repeatedly three times to make sure. I got mad at the third time. Like, whoa, if you keep asking, I'm just say yeah. Like, come on. Get rid of this napkin. It's been
in my hand for me. Sometimes I just let him go. I don't know where he's going to end up. It's all good.
Oh, man, I can't.
You're making yourself sweat more.
I know.
Nah, that's the cocaine. That
I can't with y'all.
I know about him, man. Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah, with this guy, he's a little much.
Oh,
shit.
Damn. That's good, though. That you know, I was going to say she be repping the Bronx, but no rap. That's cool. I was driving that shit the other day. This traffic over there was
I
wild.
Would hope you rap where you came from. You know.
Oh, he was messing with a chick out there. She went left. It's whatever. No. I mean, yeah, when I see you see that?
Nah,
she was like, oh, I'm sorry to hear that. My brother, you was out there?
Yeah, I was out there for mad long. That cross Bronx traffic is wild.
Packed. Yeah, don't take the cross Bronx.
It's a little late now, but thanks. I was already in it. But
So which rappers out now that you want to work out? We want to work with?
I like the baby, little baby.
Okay. Both babies, two toddlers. I see you. All right.
Don't give him that laugh. All right, keep going.
Now they're both J. Cole.
Ooh.
Okay.
Yeah. Cole
okay.
World.
Cole World. I like that. Cole World.
All right. Now I didn't want to step on your shit because I got a little gripe with Cole. This would be the perfect time for him to drop. The past 2 years has been everything he's been talking about.
Right.
We don't have any music. I'm upset. Cole's my favorite rapper.
Yeah.
Cole came to a show I did. He went out of his way to let me know I'm funny. But we need music, bro. I thought the George Floyd thing was going to bring Cole out in rare form. They were tailor made for him and Kendrick.
Yeah.
Like
Kendrick's another one.
Yeah.
Ooh, Kendrick.
Kendrick, yeah. Mm.
So. Pull up drag. Yeah.
The stories that he tells is unmatched. Like... because you know they've been talking about him and Cole dropping an album for years. George Floyd situation was perfect for that. They would have
talk about it.
I am upset. Somebody at TDE, please reach out to me. I am beside myself.
He wants a personal representative.
I am beside myself. I'll even take a
chances.
Right, Schoolboy Q, reach out to me. What is going on? Somebody let me know. J-Rock, I'm here. I need answers. Some one of you guys know this. Fucking, wow. What's my man in Dreamville with the dreads? Y'all know what I'm talking about. Little motherfucker rap his ass off. I forget his name.
I ain't the one to answer this.
J-I-D, where's Cole, bro? We need you. Maybe you can provide answers. I don't know. I don't know nobody else from Dreamville, but you know, that was it.
Everybody wear t-shirts. Where's Cole?
Yeah. Bang. That's it. Where's Cole? That's it, man. Because before the quarantine, we seen him riding through Manhattan on his bike. You know what I mean? Then he was working on his jump shot. And then he's gone.
Maybe he quarantining. I don't know.
But he, no, we need those bars.
Life is happening right now.
That's true, though. No, that's
this
true.
Is
he's riding his bars right now.
Maybe he is. I'll be coming, sneaking up on your ass.
I'll even take some Wale verses. Wale did drop a project. Shout out to my man Hovain. But Wale did drop some shit. But we need that.
The world needs.
Yeah.
Do you feel inspiration to write whenever things or big things like that happen?
Oh,
like,
absolutely. I got a crazy record about the world.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, word?
Yeah.
You got some shit? That's what's up.
Yeah, it's deep.
That's like, I was going to ask you what inspires you.
Yeah.
But, you know, it's obviously. It's,
she answered that already.
I was about to.
Yo,
I was going to say that she said it was her pain.
Oh, cold world.
I'm off that world. Who's wax, man.
Oh, now he on something.
It's a cold world.
I mean, I'm on the lemonade. What? I told you the who's wax. You put it this way. You know who wax is? He do security for Charlamagne. That's my man, Brilliant Idiots Podcast.
Okay.
Bully and the Beast. You smoke weed?
No.
All right, cool. Don't worry about it.
It fucks with the craft. I fuck with that, yeah.
No,
I sell it. Like, I'm
selling it. Ladies and gentlemen, I love that shit.
What? We could get some of the who's whack, because we got the lemonade, too.
Oh, that's crazy.
We could get some of that in the shop.
Yeah, bring it there. That's what I'm talking about. It's all about the bag.
All about the bag.
He's without these two.
That's going to be the name of the shit.
No, I'm dead ass. I'm going to connect you with my man Wax.
Okay.
We're going to get you some of the lemonade. Boom, put it in the shop. Let's do it. Ladies can sit down, get their feet done, their nails done, their hair. They even get a massage.
You on that wax.
Yo, listen, it ain't too much. Like, you know how people be like, oh, I'm going to get you. It's not like that.
It's a good vibe.
He said, and I quote, it's going to feel like your grandmother's giving you a hug. It tastes like regular lemonade. Don't taste nothing crazy. I drink the shit.
And he was fucked
both
up.
Both of my grandmothers.
Yeah, and he's talking all this calmness and shit. Up, yeah.
Nigga called me off the couch. Yo.
Put me to sleep, though.
I got you. Say no more. I got you.
This nigga called me off the couch. Yo, I ain't moving over 4 hours, B. Like,
that's that snitching shit.
Nah, it took him 2 days to recover.
But I was smoking, and I don't normally smoke, and I drank the lemonade. Oh,
this nigga was so fucked up, he went to bed at a regular bedtime.
It's still THC, though.
But it was too much for a real nigga. But... He said it feel like your grandma's giving you a hug. Both my grandmothers is dead. I was like, I'm trying to see what them heavenly hugs feel like. This shit really feel like that.
He was on a cloud.
Warm hug too. Oh. It was like my grandmother was giving me a hug, but she was a teddy bear. I was like, oh shit.
Extra soul. And he
like, it was nice. It was a good vibe. Good vibe.
No,
definitely
good vibe.
Extra soul.
We definitely that's gonna make that happen.
Type, right? That's okay. That Charmin level. I got
definitely
you.
Gonna make that shit happen. It's like the bear in the Charmin commercial.
Yeah, that. The bear is so cute.
Yeah, that
you
shit.
The bear who need to wipe his ass? All right, that's fine.
Yeah, that shit.
That's a great idea.
That shit cool. Boom. So
I forgot what the hell I was going
to. Who are some of your favorite comedians? Because I'm a comedian, he's a comedian, and she got a song she won't put out, but she got nervous.
I don't have a song.
Let me hear the song.
No. I write poetry.
Me too.
And I'm turning.
And she's putting beats behind it. So what is that?
Yeah. No, but it's not like it's not. Right. But it's not a song yet. I'm working on it. He said I had one. I'm working on it.
See, I'm not supposed to know about it because she was doing a shower line.
He fucking missed.
Yeah, he was doing it in a shower line.
He was talking all this shit last episode. Nobody told you to talk about that shit.
The shower line.
Nobody told you to talk about it.
I forgot.
You
about
knew I was on
line.
Live. What the fuck?
But nobody knew you had a big ass.
Motherfucker weird. He'd be on your live at like 3 o'clock in the morning by himself.
All right.
You go live with him.
I had all my clothes on. Let's put that one break that. Put that
I
out
had
there
my
first.
Clothes on. It was a bikini.
I did. But what I'm saying,
yeah, she naked.
He's making some other shit.
Oh, that sounded like you did something under there. It sounded like a fart.
This guy's too much, man.
Like you passing gas.
About the shower live. How do you even know she got?
She
one
was
enough?
Doing the shower live, telling her fans about you know what she's working
telling
on.
Telling you,
I'm in the live in the comments. Got niggas laughing. It's like 3-4 a.m.
Got no one laughing.
It's 4 o'clock in the morning.
It's like 3-4 a.m. She's not thinking that she's telling me that she got a song that she's trying to do. And I just bring it up from time to time. That's all that is. It's good love.
That's love. That's
love. Yeah. She said that's love or that's weird? I don't know which one it is.
Nah, hey.
Nigga on the shower line.
He mad because he wasn't in there.
I was asleep. So I'm going to bring it up.
Because he wants to put in a group chat.
Oh, man. Let the streets know. Fuck.
The streets is not in the group chat.
They're going to be next time. God damn it.
Yo.
But, no. I can't. Nah, all right. Come on. Reel it in.
Yeah. It's the Lord's Day. Let's reel it in.
You right. Motherfucker sweat that cocaine kicking his ass.
I'll right? be sweating shit cord. Funny. I'm
why
only
are we talking about cocaine, though?
I don't do anything.
I don't.
No, I'm a Christian.
You just said that.
Nah, it's all good. It's all good. So boom, we got the nail salon jumping.
Oh,
to
man.
Spa.
Do we got the single cash out?
We got the single cash out jumping.
Jumping.
Mate, it's right behind it. Jumping.
D Rose out here in these streets.
D-Rose outside, yeah, rolling like he D Rose.
Wait, Dirk. Never
mind. No, AB about wrong. To push that button on you. You good.
But you know, that's thanks. Such a good thing. Because one thing he always talks, like one conversation we always have is, you know, yeah, we stand up comedians, but it's more than just stand up, you know?
Right.
It's stand up, it's acting, it's even a podcast. It's everything that we do. You know, we got to have multiple ventures.
Let me tell you, let me. He
go
asked
ahead.
Me, so you got Kevin Hart, who's my favorite comedian. You got Young Fly.
Okay.
I like Martin.
Yeah.
And now, I love Martin. Wellies. Alex, you know what I'm saying? Y'all got me over here, cheeks hurting, catching.
All right.
I got to tell y'all.
I didn't have your cheeks hurting.
I got to shout.
Did I have your cheeks hurt?
Oh, you have my cheeks. Oh.
I told you, she gonna shoot a shot.
Why not?
She gonna shoot a shot.
I wanted to be in tune with everybody.
Wait,
really?
Right? Really?
I wanted to be included.
Yes, yeah, she, like, don't forget.
Yeah.
She said, oh, you got
she
my cheeks.
She gonna shoot a shot.
You can lie through it, okay?
So I had your cheeks hurting too.
Like, whoa.
I didn't
sound
like that.
Of the room,
I didn't sound like that. I didn't sound like that.
Oh, shit. That's funny.
Nah, DC Young Fly is real funny. I did Rutgers University with DC. And everybody was saying at the time that he's just funny on social media. Nah, DC real funny.
Yeah.
Yeah, nah, we had fun that night. Shout out to DC, man. Nah, that's a... Yo, I always say, like, Jamie Foxx got to be the most talented comedian ever. And I don't even want to just call him a comedian because
he does everything, hit records, he do
action movies now.
He's doing a sitcom right now too on Netflix
with his daughter. Shout out to Jamie.
Crazy.
Man,
he's doing it all.
But so you moved down to Atlanta, but you're from the Bronx. Do you believe people got to move out of where they from to get to have success?
Oh, good question.
They don't gotta, nah, you don't gotta move out to have success, but you gotta move out to have growth. You're gonna
say that again. Say what you just said one more time. Go ahead. Say it again.
You don't gotta move out to have success, but you gotta move out to have growth.
Ladies and gentlemen, good night. That right there. Yep.
That the right end there. Of the show. That's the show.
Do you see what you just said?
Nah, because you don't realize what you in until you out of it. So now when I'm here, I see all this. Yeah, man. Yesterday, I was about to take my sneakers off. No, you know what I mean? I'm about to get crazy. But I had to be like, you know what? I move. You know what I mean? You got to get home. You got to get back home safe. You know what I mean? But this is the truth. Like, you don't realize it until you out. Stop.
Yeah,
out.
You realize how big of a place the world is. And it's more than just where you came from.
And I learned so much being out. You know what I mean? The more you travel, the more you learn. You learn different cultures. You learn how people are. You study people. Everybody's different. And every place you go to, they're different.
You're absolutely right. It is about growth because everywhere you go is different. So you gotta expand your palate.
Mm-hmm.
That's absolutely right.
You know, some people stay where they're at and then they wonder why they're not going anywhere. They're not.
Too many people.
Yeah, a lot of people don't see
that comfort zone.
And then, you know, they're going to be, you know, I guess a little older and then wish that they could go back in time and like change their ways and shit like
then
that.
People go, you change. You'd be like, no, yeah. You didn't change.
Exactly.
Yes. People act like change is so bad.
And then
bad.
They want to call you Hollywood.
Right? No, yeah. No. Acting funny. That now word, you acting funny. No, I'm not acting
that
funny.
Phrase,
I am
you're
funny. You're not. That's
you
the
acting
problem.
Hollywood. Yeah, well, those phrases kill me.
Yeah, I'm acting funny because I'm in a call now. Okay, yeah.
So we got a segment on the show called Truth or Truth. Normally, we go around the room. Everybody just asks everybody one question. Whatever the hell you want. But we've been asking you questions the whole episode. So we're going to switch it up. You get to ask us whatever you want. You could give us one question for the room. Or you could just rattle off them with the steam. Blah, blah, blah. Hit up three questions, niggas. Anything you want. Truth or truth. Dirty Diana. Let's go.
What you say made you the most money?
She's all about the bag. I fucks with that.
Yeah.
I fucks with that.
That your light bulb went off and you said, this is what's going to bring in the money. All of that has just been...
All right. For me, acting.
Okay.
It was because you could do stand up, but acting brings you more money in stand up. You understand what I'm saying? And then it's like when you look at, all right, so if we remove acting, comedy really don't pay a lot of money. But if you act for a day on set, you make more money than most people make in a month.
There you go.
Ooh, let us
that
know.
One
That's
day.
Deep. That's what
let
I'm
us know.
Talk to me. And, ask me up.
And then it's like, you, boom, you acting. Acting gonna get you more money per verse now.
There you go.
That's yeah.
It goes hand in hand.
It worked that way.
Up. It goes
so
exactly.
So acting definitely is brings me the most money. You know what I mean?
Good to know.
Yeah.
He's like, oh, I'm in a movie. My price just went up.
These Jews.
Yeah, I got, oh, by the way, I got a new TV show coming out May 6th, the Peacock Network, Tina Fey's new show, Girls 5 Ever. I'm in this episode 6. Go check that out. Go ahead. Any next question?
Dope.
Yeah. We got any stream.
So it's one question each, right?
You could rile over.
Yeah, it
doesn't matter.
Your show, pretty much. Go ahead. Rock out.
Doesn't matter.
Your show.
When did you realize it was acting for you? What made you decide?
Well, I learned a lot of what I learned from him. So he's been doing this a lot longer than me. So a lot of the lessons that I've been getting comes from him. But what I can say is, his logic checked out just from what I watched. Look at like Eddie Murphy, you know? He did stand up at first, then he was in hella movies. Beverly Hills Cop, then he was in fucking Harlem Nights, and then even to like the kid level, he was in Shrek, everything. Mm-hmm. Now it's like, once you have that notoriety, everybody knows you. Mm-hmm. Then it's like, all right, now I want to see what you do. Kevin Hart's following that same blueprint right now. He's doing all the movies. He's doing all the commercials, all the, you know, the Coldest Balls, all the YouTube series, all of that shit. So it's like, you see him everywhere. Mm-hmm. Now he can travel the world and do stand-up.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
You know, that's how he could demand the money he demands on stand-up, by doing a YouTube series or whatever. Wow. But yeah.
Last thing I'm going to just say on that is, I was actually watching his series on Netflix where he's called Don't Fuck This Up, and he said something about London. He said he filmed his last special.
Real quick, can I just put this out there? I was in that, but...
What that got to do with
that's
the point?
Because me,
what that got to do with the point?
Because me and Shadow was in it. We was in it, and then they didn't use that footage because.
So you're not in it.
Yo.
I thought he was the hater. I thought it was him. It was her the whole time. Go ahead, guys. But good content. Good content.
To finish my point. He said one thing when he started doing arenas, London was showing him so much love. And that just goes to show the amount of reach that he had from, you know, not just social media, but from everything he was doing. So it just goes to show you definitely want your name to be everywhere so that when you do come back to the stand-up, you can do the arenas, you can do everything else. So, but that's when I realized it, you know, it just kind of made sense. That's what the greats are doing. I'm gonna do what the greats are doing. But yeah.
That's good.
Watching.
And for you, so... You kept mentioning the industry. So as a female, what you do, you find it hard that in the industry is like a male dominant? Is it tough? Like, is men always trying to come onto you? Like, what makes you comfortable? Like, what is your comfortability with dealing with this industry? Because I see you are a host, you know what I mean?
I mean, first I started off like doing runway shoots, pageants, and then I got my first, I guess, letdown. And I kind of steered a different way. And then, you know, I got into like eye candy, then the lingerie. But I felt like I was curvy at the time, so I wasn't this thin. And America's Next Top Model at the time, they weren't. So I guess now they both sexes are on the TV now, well, okay, on that show. But a lot of things evolved. But I feel like, you know, I learned a lot of things along the way. So now I can actually notice that guys kind of see a difference in my energy. Maybe when I started out, I was probably a little too friendly and stuff, but a lot of people, you know, took advantage of my naive, you know, self. And I was very, like I said, I'm friendly. I have a personality. I like to talk too much, as you can fucking see right now. I'm talking too much. But see, I even lose my train of thought. But yeah, now I feel like I have, the last few shoots these months have been great. You know, the guys have not been disrespectful except this one incident. But this guy, you know, I forgot about that one. But they were doing too much, right, you know? And it's like,
some niggas love doing too much. That's niggas' favorite thing to do.
That's your favorite thing.
But people can do too much in a respectful way.
Do everything too damn much. That's
people
what
can do too much sometimes in a respectful way because we're doing business. But, you know, it is kind of hard, yeah. I feel like they do try to kind of control you in some ways too, as far
as your comfortability level.
It's I'm pretty comfortable now, but I feel like, you know, I had to change that. Like, I had to change my ways. So now I'm definitely on a scale of 1 to 10. 10, I'm comfortable. Okay. But sometimes that might be bad for me.
Right,
you know,
cool,
being too comfortable in church.
That's what's up. Said niggas be doing too much. You niggas.
No.
Why?
No, I just feel like people.
And this is the last question for everybody. So what's going on the ways of the world? You know what I mean? Everything that's going on in the world right now, COVID, everything. Is it, do you think it inspired you to spend more time with your family and stuff like that? Or do you think it's more of a stuck in the house type fear of, you know, we losing a lot of people, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I'll answer this question. Mm-hmm.
Well, I feel it's still time to go get that bizag.
That's what I'm talking.
Still gotta get that bag. The COVID just taught us you gotta focus on the other things you do well. You can't just you can't just do one thing. If you act, you better start writing. You know what I mean? Like it focus on everything, because for a while acting was even shut down.
Wow.
Like I was booked on a show, that TV show that we couldn't film because they just kept getting shut down. Wow. Like, because one person contracts the virus, they got to shut everything down because everybody working together. So I had to write it. Well, I don't want to say I had to write a TV show, but I wrote a TV show and a movie during the quarantine. It just forced you to step your other shit up. Dope. And I think that's what everyone's been, everybody got comfortable, everybody got in the comfort zone. And when God wants you to sit your ass down, you're going to sit it down. Fact. You're going to sit it right down.
That's fact.
Maybe the world needed us to do that. The sky has never been as clear as it was during the quarantine. You know what I mean? No airplanes going by. Mm-hmm. It was
actually, yeah, I didn't even think about
it. We had a curfew to be in the house. Like, you know what I mean?
Yo, that's
yeah.
Crazy.
God, and then the fireworks were going crazy. So, you know, that's what I feel. It just forced you to step up. The other things you say you do well, do them. The things you didn't have time to do them.
Facts.
To add on to that, one thing I would just say is it tests your resolve too. Are you serious about what it is that you're doing? You know, one thing, we used to have conversations all the time during the pandemic, and he would be like, everybody in the world right now has all the time that they've always been asking for.
Yeah, because everybody was saying too busy.
Everybody's like, I'm time. Too busy to do this activity, too busy to start this dream, to write this book, to make this article, right? But now you have time. So it's like, what are you going to do with this time, you know? You're just going to sit around and chill? I sat around and chilled for a minute, but after a while, it's like, you're like, well, you know what? Are you serious about what it is that you want to do, you know? Nobody can walk out of this pandemic, walk out of quarantine and say, well, I wish I had time to do. You just had a whole year's worth of time. So yeah. It's like, you know?
People don't understand time is so important.
It's the most valuable thing. Yeah.
Everything is time.
They're not making more time. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? They're not making more. Right. Like time and real estate, they're not making no more of that.
Yeah.
That's it. You got to make the most of both of them.
And the crazy thing with X, going back to DMX, mm-hmm. You know, he gave me his number and we was getting ready to work. Bitch, I need the studio. Give me your personal like number. No motherfucking blackouts. Fuck you, man, bitch.
Real bitch. Let him ride with the stick. Cash out. Every time I'm in this bitch. Baby fix. They thinking that I'm in this.
Yeah, time's not promised to no one.
Yeah.
We've all heard that, but when you experience it, it means something different. You know what I mean?
It makes you start looking at opportunities like this might not happen again.
Word.
That's true.
But, yo, this was a great episode. I enjoy having
this
you.
This was fun as hell.
This y'all are incredible. I'm telling you, I'm on my list now. Thank you. Cheek hurt.
This was fun as hell. You have no idea.
Anything you want to plug real quick?
Go ahead.
Oh, man. Shout out to my team. And shout out to everybody that's been supporting me from day one. AB, you know the vibes.
All right.
Ricky Game Entertainment. Shout out to Head Crack. Shout out to everybody that's just been supporting. My mom, my fam's here.
Right.
I mean, I keep people around me that I know that got my back.
Mm-hmm. Preach.
Shout out to y'all for having me.
Of course.
All right. So, like, you mentioned the people that you keep around you. Which one of them got that thing on them?
she's playing around.
I know. Right, she got the bag. It's in the bag.
Playing around. All right. This motherfucker going to get us all in trouble. All right. That's it. Thank you all for watching. This is Wellies World Podcast. Rate, review, subscribe to us on YouTube. Check us out on all platforms. Motherfucker going to get us killed. Good night, everybody.
Dirty Diana, man. Go check that out. Cash out right now.
I cash out like it's no motherfucking blackouts. Fuck you, mean bitch. Real bitch. Let her ride with the stick. Cash out. Every time I'm in this bitch. Baby fix, they thinking that I'm innocent. Cash out.